Okay, anak-anak. Now we have come to our last video, video number 4. Hopefully this is your last video for this particular chapter. Okay. This video is about interest rate parity theory, IRP. This is the last theory that we will learn under parity conditions theory. Okay, the interest rate parity theory is a theory in which the interest rate differential between two countries is equal to the differential between the forward exchange rate and the spot exchange rate. Apa ke benda pula ni? Okay, baik, relax, bertenang. Okay, in this theory, kita nak tengok, okay, you have learned how to calculate forward discount and forward premium of the currencies, right? The exchange rate currency between two countries, okay? Alright. So, under this theory, dia kata, kalaulah forward premium or forward discount tu in percentage tu equals to the interest rate differential between two countries, okay? We can say the interest rate parity condition is achieved. Ha, kalau nilai forward discount or premium tu, okay, sama dengan perbezaan interest between two countries. Okay, home minus foreign countries punya interest. Home interest minus foreign country punya interest. Okay. Kalaulah tak sama, apa yang akan berlaku? Katakan yang ni lebih besar ke? Interest differential, rate differential besar daripada forward discount or premium ke? Or lebih kecil ke? Kalau tak sama, maksudnya apa? The theory is not helped. Kalau the theory is not held, tak tercapai, okay, it's not prevail, it's not achieved. So, the traders, okay, will try to make profit by borrowing and investing simultaneously in these two countries. Or in these two different currency. Kalaulah you dapat ni, tak sama. Apa yang tak sama? Forward di premium or discount ni, tak sama dengan interest rate differential. Kalau sama, tak boleh buat borrowing and investing. Okay? Tengok contoh. By using the following example, plug in the figures in the assumption. Okay, kita masih guna contoh yang tadi. Alright, contoh that we have in our last videos. Okay. Given to you Malaysia and Singapore. Okay. But this time around, kita nak tengok ada opportunity untuk kita buat arbitraging ke tak by borrowing and investing. First and foremost, we will find the forward discount or premium. Okay, how to calculate the forward premium or discount? Kita akan ambil forward rate minus spot rate over 360 days over N. N ni dalam kes setahun 360 jugalah times 100%. So, you will take 1.8405 minus 2.99 over 2.99 this part times 360 over 360 times 100%. Kita nak tengok adakah sama dengan interest rate differential. Ambil I of home currency minus I of foreign currency. When we calculate the answer, you will get, ini macam approximate lah bunda-bunda, memang you akan dapat negative 5. This one is also negative 5. Maksudnya apa? The interest rate parity condition is achieved, is held, tercapai. So, there is no opportunity for us to do arbitrage. Apa maksud dia kat sini? Okay, ada setengah trader, dia untung macam ni tau. Dia borrow dekat satu negara, duit yang dia pinjam tu dia pergi labur kat negara lain untuk buat untung dengan syarat investment di negara sana lebih menguntungkan dengan mengambil kira forward rate waktu tu. Dengan mengambil kira forward rate yang dia bagi. Okay, so meaning kalau dah keadaan ni sama, macam contoh yang dapat ni, if the parity condition exists, it means that investing and borrowing simultaneously in these two countries, will not give you any opportunity for you to make profit. Because why? At the end of the day, either borrowing from any of these two countries will cost the trader the same amount of earning. Jumlah meminjam dengan jumlah pulangan pelaburan akan jadi sama je. Tak menguntungkan. Kalau ini tak sama, baru kita boleh buat borrowing and lending. Lending tu maksudnya investing lah. Okay. Kita tengok contoh. And of course, in your test, in your final exam, you akan dapat disparity condition. Condition yang disparity ataupun disequilibrium. If there is disequilibrium between these two, okay, antara forward premium and discount dengan interest rate differential tu tak sama, maka there is opportunity for you to do covered interest arbitrage. Okay. We can say that the covered interest arbitrage exists kalau berlaku disequilibrium. Okay. The parity assumption is violated. How does it work? Okay. Kita Dia kata apa? Actually, the notion behind covered interest arbitrage is for the trader to borrow in the country. And sebenarnya bila kita buat covered interest arbitrage ni, we can borrow in the country that offer lower interest rate and invest in country that offer higher interest rate. At the same times, okay, kita akan guna forward rate yang ada tu to protect our position, to protect our arbitrage, okay, to make sure that our arbitrage will give us profit sebab kita dah hedge kita dah secure kita punya position dengan enter into forward contract. Forward contract tu kita ambil kira. Kita buat contoh lah. Nak faham senang, kita kena buat contoh. By violating the assumption, let's take a look at illustration below. Okay. Katakan ni Encik Ali eh. He can borrow or lend, alright, or invest GBP 10 million ringgit and the bank provide the following information. Okay. USD dengan GBP. Okay. Dia bagi USD 8%, GBP 12%, spot rate USD per GBP 1.6, 1 year forward rate. Okay. 1 year forward rate dia bagi USD 1.53 per GBP. Determine whether CIA, bukan CIA penyiasat tu, badan penyiasat tu, ini cover interest arbitrage opportunity exists or not. And if the firm takes the arbitrage opportunity on the interest rate, find the firm's profit in USD. Ha. Jadi USD ni kita punya home lah. GBP kita punya for foreign. Okay. Alright. So to determine whether CIA opportunity wujud exist or not, so we have to do this first step first. Okay. Kita highlight balik apa information yang dia bagi. Saya letak dalam kotak. Kita akan identify either forward premium or discount ni sama tak dengan interest rate differential. So, we put in all the figures that we have in the column there. Masukkan dalam formula. Kita dapati forward discount ni berapa? Negative 4.375. Interest rate differential berapa? 8 - 12 equals to negative 4. Home interest minus foreign interest. Jadi, nampak tak? Tak sama. Bila tak sama, what does it mean? It means that the opportunity to do covered interest arbitrage exist. Boleh. Kita boleh buat arbitrage. Kita boleh pinjam dan invest. Okay. Step 2, kita nak decide pula where to borrow where and where to invest. To calculate this, ini formula dia. Kita akan bandingkan antara 1 plus I of home currency dengan 1 plus I of foreign currency times forward rate over spot rate. Okay. Alright. Kalau yang home punya, US punya berapa? 8%. So, 1.08. Yang sini pula, 1 tambah 0.12, 1.12 times with future contract over future contract lagi, sorry. Times with forward rate over spot rate. You akan dapat 1.071. Bila kita compare, alright, we can see that in the foreign country, the value that you calculate is lower than the value in home country. So, what does it mean? Kita akan melabur di tempat yang lebih besar nilai dia dengan dan kita akan borrow di negara yang lebih rendah nilai dia. So, yang sebelah sini adalah apa? UK, sebab foreign tu adalah UK. Ini adalah US, 1.08. So, kita mula-mula kita kena pinjam dulu tau anak-anak. Kita kena pinjam, barulah kita boleh labur. Tidak, kita nak melabur macam mana kalau tak ada duit? So, we borrow in foreign country UK at 12%. Ha? Jangan ambil 1.07 ni, 12% ni. Ambil 12%. And at the same time, after we borrow, we will invest that money in our home country, which is US pada 8%. Okay. So, kita dah tentukan where to borrow, where to invest. How much you will borrow or invest? 10 million GBP. Okay. Alright, so kita akan borrow GBP 10 million. Ha, memang kita kata tadi borrow in UK. Bila borrow in UK, so we plug in the figure here. Okay, kenapa positif? Sebab kita borrow, kita dapat duit. Duit tu kita dapat dalam GBP. Alright, and then we are going to invest the amount of money dekat mana? Dekat US. Jadi, kenapa jadi negatif? Sebab duit tu kita akan bawa ke, kita convert kepada USD. Bila kita convert, we will take 10 million GBP, kita darat dengan spot rate tadi, USD 1.6. So, USD 1.6 GBP rate dia, so ambil GBP 10 million times USD 1.6, you dapat 16 million. Kenapa jadi negatif? Sebab GBP tu dia tak wujud dah, dia dah jadi USD. And then, we will use the money yang kita dah convert from GBP to invest in US at 8%. So, keluarlah duit tu. Pergi mana? Pergi dalam, kita melabur dalam US. Okay? Dekat negara, dekat US lah. Okay. After 1 year, pelaburan tu menghasilkan pulangan. You invest at 8%. So, kita nak tahulah berapa pulangan from the investment. So, you take 16 million USD tadi times 1.08. So, you akan dapat 17.28 million USD. And then, okay, kita akan convert balik kepada GBP. Kenapa? Jangan lupa kita pinjam duit in GBP. So, you have to pay it, GBP lah. So, kita convert duit tadi 17.28 juta kepada GBP. Nak convert gunalah exchange rate forward rate tu. Kita dah lock pada forward rate 1.53. USD bertemu USD, kita bahagi. So, hilanglah duit kat USD ni, dah jadi dalam bentuk GBP. Okay, inilah kita punya pulangan bila pelaburan kita bila kita convert into GBP. Don't forget how much did you borrow 10 million ringgit at 12%. So how did you get nilai ni? Ambil 10 million ringgit times interest pinjaman kita 12%, 1.12. This is the total amount that you have to pay. So the amount of investment kat sini, jumlah bayar hutang kat sini. So lepas you minus, you akan dapat GBP 94,117 ringgit. Tapi sebab modal kita adalah orang, kononnya orang US, you convert lah balik dalam US. Nak convert ni, darat lah balik dengan 1.53. Tapi dia tak cakap pun dia nak minta untung tu dalam apa. Kalau you leave it in GBP pun it's okay. Kalau you convert into USD pun it's okay. So meaning to say, alright, bila berlaku disequilibrium, alright, dalam teori ni, kita boleh meminjam duit pinjam tu, we invest. After we invest, we make some money and then we use the money to pay the loan. But still, since the amount that we receive is higher than the amount of loan that we have to pay, we still can make money. Bayangkan dalam setahun you dah boleh buat 94,000 GBP. Kalau dalam USD, 144,000. Okay, so when the parity condition is not held, ataupun tidak tercapai, we can do covered interest arbitrage. Okay, let's do another example in our next video. Oh, this is not your last video. Okay, ada lagi video. Okay, see you.